When is the best time to do Roth conversions? In today's episode, we're going to talk about what you need to be looking for each year when you go and make that decision if you want to do a Roth conversion, if that's right for you. So we're going to give you a few tips here. So let's take a look at this chart here to get a better feel of the best time to do Roth conversions each year. So what I like about this chart is actually pretty interesting. So it's taking the S&P 500, as you can see up in the top left hand, and it's taking it all the way through basically 2022. And what it's going to show in the blue here is a calendar year return. So that's what it actually did for that year. For example, 2021, it was up about 29%. But in the entry year drawdown, that means that that was the most it went down during that year. So it was down 5% that year. And so that's not that big of a deal there. But in a year like 2020, if you remember COVID, the market was down 34% during that year. And it finished the year up 18%, as you can see. So what does that tell us as an investor? Well, we need to stay the course, right? That's first and foremost. The second thing is, what are we doing when it drops 34%? If you've seen any of my other videos or heard me talk before, I use the term, it's time to go. And this is a prime example of when it could be time to go. For example, when the market goes down 34%, maybe that's a chance to convert that money to a Roth, pay the taxes now, so that when it grows and goes back up to that 18%, all of that growth is tax-free and you don't have to worry about it anymore. And so this is a strategy that we do with our clients. We take a very close eye on the market. Obviously, we don't have any control over the market does, but we can have a choice or a decision of what we want to do when we expect the market to be down, you know, among the lowest that it may be. And understand, you're not going to get this perfect. No one knows exactly when the market bottom is, but the goal is to try to take the best shot of when you can. Another prime example was in 2022, which isn't listed on this chart, but as you remember, market went down about 20%, and in 2023, it's starting to climb back up. And so that's something that we have to consider that, hey, if we did a Roth conversion at the bottom last year, all this growth coming back up that we're seeing is tax-free. So it's pretty neat, and you can go back to any year. And what I like about this chart is it shows you that just about every year you're going to see an opportunity where the market was down farther than what it really ended up at. You know, for example, let's look at 2009 here. The market ended up 27%, but it's seen a drawdown of 27%. So those are great opportunities to really do this concept that I'm talking about. And so you can look at this chart to see the different opportunities each year. Another point I want to make is that, you know, a lot of people always really want to try to go to that sweet spot when doing Roth conversions. You know, for some of those people, if you're not collecting Social Security yet, maybe that's to the top of the 12% bracket. Maybe if you're higher income earner and you have a larger amount in tax deferred assets, maybe the sweet spot is the 24% bracket, or maybe it's to the first Medicare premium tier if you're 63 or older. Whatever it may be for you, a time when the market is down could be an opportunity where you maybe consider doing more of a Roth conversion. For example, let's say in 2019 here, as I'm showing you, the market was down 34%. And you may think, well, I don't want to convert anymore because then I'll put myself into the 32% bracket. Majority of the times, you are right, and we would tell our clients, let's not worry about converting more. Although if the market's down that much and we're expecting it to come back up, maybe it does make sense to pay a 32% tax because you're not going to be paying any more tax on the growth coming back. So those are some things that you want to consider, especially if you have the 12 to 22% brackets, all things to consider when doing a Roth conversion. Okay, so those are some just points you want to look at here. So two points I want to summarize here. One, stay invested for the long term. Don't let these little ups and downs bother you because obviously if you look at it every day, it's really going to get to you. The second thing I want to emphasize is really understand the best times to do Roth conversions throughout the year. What we do with a lot of our clients is since we can't time the market, maybe we'll do two sets of Roth conversions throughout the year. Maybe we'll do one, you know, towards the beginning of the year if we feel like the market's going to be down at that point. And then maybe we'll shore up the difference at the end to get a better feel to make sure that we can close in on that expected Roth conversion amount that will maximize their sweet spot that we just talked about there. So that's really the key there. And again, we'd like to do Roth conversions at the end of the year if we can, because that's when we're going to get the clearest example of what your income is. For example, we had a client just retire early in the year, and they were pretty set on doing a Roth conversion up until the next sweet spot for them. And we told them, I don't think we should do it yet. I think we should wait. And one of those reasons why is because, hey, you may go back to work. And he said, I'm not going back to work. But we knew how he was. We've been working with him for long enough to know that he'd probably go back to work. Sure enough, about a month later, they call him. They give him about double the salary he would have gotten. And he decided to go back to work. And obviously, that changed the Roth conversion amount that we ended up doing later in that year. So those are just some things to consider as you make this decision. So hopefully you like this video. Go ahead and leave a comment. Let us know what other videos you would like. Is this a video that you enjoyed? What did you enjoy about it? And give us some other ideas of videos to do. Enjoy the rest of your day.